Many of the languages you likely know about can change the form of their words to show grammatical information. Even English does this to an extent. We can add an S to words like cat, lorry, or lecture to show that we're talking about more than one of these: cats, lorries, and lectures. But different languages do this to different extents. In English, the ways which we can change words are fairly limited. There aren't many things you can add to make grammatical meaning. Other languages can add a lot more. In Turkish, it's not uncommon to find words with strings of 4 or 5 different elements on a word, each adding little grammatical nuances that in English we might require multiple words to express. These are called agglutinative languages. But what about on the other end of the spectrum? We've seen that English doesn't allow many elements to be added to its words, but it does still allow some. There are actually also languages, such as Vietnamese, Yoruba, and Thai, which allow next to no elements to be added on to any of their words. Each word is just the word alone, and grammar has to be shown using more individual words. These are what we call isolating languages.